Okay, Eastern European confessionals. Scott, what was your favorite place and why?
My favorite place was Dubrovnik, which is close between Dubrovnik and Budapest. But I would have to say Dubrovnik. It was just a really neat city. I had never seen anything like it, and the fact that it's right on the ocean. Culture. Definitely somewhere that everyone should go check out.
Okay. What's the funniest thing that happened?
Funniest thing, we were in Budapest, and we were taking the subway around, and we figured we didn't want to buy another ticket. We changed lines, and we didn't want to buy another ticket. We figured we could just play dumb tourists, and we got caught, and like the official tried to make us pay this ridiculous fine. We were arguing with them and all that. We actually ended up getting off for like 5 or 6 or 7 euro. But the funny thing was is that like we were so upset with him, and when we were done, we were yelling at how like he shouldn't have fined us, and you know we didn't know what we were doing, and it's very confusing. But the whole time we were doing it, we knew that we were breaking the law, and we knew we were like, oh, we'll just see if we can get away with it. And for some reason, we felt like we were rationalizing the entire thing.
Okay, your least favorite place?
My least favorite, same as Kim, is Zagreb in Croatia. But it's no means like a knock on the place. It was very nice. Just in comparison to every other place we've been in Eastern Europe, it was at the bottom, but still a really cool city.
Okay, most surprising thing?
Most surprising thing, Eastern Europe's been like ravaged by war, like not so long ago, early 90s, and especially in Dubrovnik, and it's amazing to see how far they've come in this short time, in like 16 or 17 years, to rebuild the city.
Okay, and your favorite saying?
Favorite saying, it's probably the only thing I actually know because all languages are so difficult to learn. In Hungarian, to say cheers, you say ishin ishin. That's it.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.